To access the module database, we're going to use the PI module database editor. It is included in the PI system management tools application, and it's designed as a way or methodology to manage your module database on an individual PI server or many PI servers. And I've got a copy of my PI system management tools open. I've connected to my PI server, and I will expand the operation tab, and under operation you will find module database. Now on my machine, if I scroll down, you'll see the only thing that's here by default is the heading sets entry. We'll see that at a later time in the class. And a module database tree. The top level is modules. Now there is a module called %OSI, and we don't recommend that people open that up or change anything in it or play with it. That is sort of a little registry of our applications, for OSI applications, and we don't recommend people modify that. So what I want to do is I want to build a module database structure, just an example structure. I'm going to right click on modules and select new, and I get a dialog box that's got new module. It's a new module name. I'm going to call this my company. And I'll describe a lot of these fields a little bit later as we go through the class. But right now, I'm just going to give the module name a name, and I'm going to leave the description and comment blank for right now. And you'll see that I have a module called My Company, and I'll put a new production line module there. I'll right click and select New and Module, and I'll call this Production Line 1. And I will put in one piece of machinery in this production line, and I'll call this piece of machinery Press 23. Now, Press 23 is a physical entity, and as we said earlier, the modules that represent physical entities, and in fact all modules, but most of the time you will tie these to modules that represent physical entities. We can tie aliases and properties to this module. So the first thing I want to do is I want to tie an alias to this module. So I'll right click and select alias. The alias I'm going to use is called pressure, and I have a certain hydraulic pressure associated with this press. And I can either select my PI server and type in my tag name, or I can use the tag search button and use the familiar tag search functionality that most people that use PI are familiar with. I'm going to just use one of my random tags and tie it to this. I'll use my BA level tag. This is just an example, so I don't have to tie a real tag to this. And I'll click OK. And you can see here that we do in fact have an alias. I want to do the same thing for properties as well. I'm going to say I want to know what the target pressure is, or what we'll call the max pressure. And I want to store that as a property because I know what that value is. That's part of the specifications for the lines and the pump and the equipment. So I'll call this property max pressure. And you can see we can store almost any type of data type. I'm going to use a double. And the max pressure I'm going to say is 32.567. And I'll click OK. And we can see that we have pressure and max pressure. And if I want to actually see what these values are in this view, I right click out in the open area and select Show and Aliases and Property Values. And that will show me what my pressure tag is and my max pressure. I can now use these elements in a display or in a report. I can look at the current value for pressure and compare it to my max pressure in a trend or report or something else. So the module database editor is generally what we'll use to create modules, aliases, and properties. With this last piece of information, we can fill in the label on the final point of our jigsaw puzzle. If you remember, we started with the PI archives. The PI archives store the process values and actually the batch information. We'll examine that later. It's the PI batch database stores all of the batch records. It's what we query to find out what batches were running during a certain start and end time or against a certain product or recipe. The module database organizes our process and stores all of the batch configuration information. And finally, our plugins to SMT. We saw the module database editor. We also have a batch database plugin as well as a PI archive plugin. All of these elements fit together and form the batch system within PI.